Hey, Commander players, another game with the Daretti. This hand's pretty bad. So I'm gonna mulligan. This hand's worse. My lord. Mulligan. Eh. But at least I got the Vandal Blast. And at least I'm playing against five colors. Five colors tend to be take a little while to get built up. So if I draw another land, I can at least get out Gilded Lotus by sacrificing the Generator Servant. Come on. Oh. Well, that sucks. Let's play Daretti. Let's get rid of these guys. There we go. This may be an arduous affair. To say the least, we certainly did not have the advantage in this. But, maybe we could still pull it off. Maybe. Oh man, he's getting land screwed too. He should have kept, you know, mulliganing like I had to do. Mulligan again and again. I think I'd discard the Gilded Lotus. And then next turn I can sacrifice the Mer Retriever. Yeah. So this started out really terrible, and it looks like he's getting a little screwed, which I'm assuming means he has like a Cultivate or something in his hand. The fact that I can Daretti without having to Daretti is pretty nice. Maybe. Cyclonic Rift. Alright. I don't even care. Wouldn't need my whole night. So I, sacrifice, bring back the Gilded Lotus, bring back the Worm Coil Engine, play said Worm Coil Engine. Hopefully he doesn't just counter it. And pass the turn. That was a pretty productive turn, I think. Yep. Let's add another one to this afterwards. Hey guys, Gary here again with some more Daretti. This hand looks pretty fucking stupid, like in a good way. Playing against Nahiri. Battle of the Planeswalkers. I wonder if it's stock. Seems like a good way to get people to join is to take a bite of candy. Because it seems like they join almost instantly after that. So, I will have a turn 2 Daretti. him getting the swords, the fire and ice, isn't too big of a deal because I can goblin wielder it away. So, they can't even be mad. I mean, tutoring for the thing that gives you protection from my entire deck, that's pretty strong. Oh, it's another person who enjoys playing slow as shit. I understand that people have to make decisions and whatnot, and that can be time-consuming, but he's got two possible land. I just don't see where you're going to be making too many decisions. So he gets another tutor. I wonder if he's going to go for War and Peace. Oh, you mean he just now added it to the stack? Okay. Oh, Argent of Armor. I recognize you. Always heads. Ooh, Unwinding Clock. Let's see here. So, let's get out Daretti. And let's discard up to two cards. I think it'll be this and the Unwinding Clock. Ooh. Get the welder out. He gets to cheat in an Argentum Armor, or more likely a Swords to Plow, Swords, Sword of Fire and Ice, not Swords to Plowshare. I will play my Wellspring and bring back the Hedron. He has 3 mana now, so he has to take probably a good 35 minutes to decide what he's going to do. That's how he roll. That's what he do. He do nothing. There have been people arguing that this chick is now this chick, that this person unlocked their plane, they got their Planeswalker spark and became this person. And I think that those people are full of shit, because this is a profession, not a proper noun, you know, such as someone named Nahiri the Lithomancer. So it's kind of like the square and a rectangle. This Nahiri could be a Stoneforge mystic, but not all Stoneforge mystics became Nahiri. So, just a little a nitpick of people who like to say that she planeswalked into this. If he's got another land next turn, he can Stoneforge Mystic and equip the swords. Mycosynth Lattice. That is such... That's such a mean card in this deck. I love it. Fucking love it. Let's draw a card. Play a land. Let's draw another card and get the Hedron. And draw another, yeah. Okay. Oh man, that is so mean. But I love it. Let's leave one red. Actually do this right. Inferno Titan. Yep, 2 and 1. Okay. Because I don't need him cheating stuff out to play. And then let's discard a couple things. Oh, Scuttling Doom Engine. You are so fun and mean. Funny thing is if I bring out the Mycosynth Lattice, and then I can bring back Bogard and Hellkite with the Welder or the Daretti -2 activation, and that is just some silly, silly stuff, I tell you what. Alright, you can go ahead and Skull Clamp. I'm okay with that. You be you, girl. Striker 8989, so creative. Yep. If he attacks, I don't block. Honestly, I'm surprised he equipped. Because he can do that at instant speed. Yeah, I don't block here. I let Daretti take the damage. And I just swing in for a bunch with my Titan. Oh, again, I gotta get rid of this. I keep forgetting. Let's see. Let's discard 2. But I'm only gonna discard 1. Mystifying Muse. Okay. Let's play Scuttling Doom Engine. And then let's Goblin Welder Scuttling Doom Engine. No, let's not do that. Undo. Let's undo again. Fire Diamond. Let's get rid of the Fire Diamond and bring back the Unwinding Clock, I think. I think that's the right thing. No, let's undo again. Okay. Sacrifice, and let's bring back Unwinding Clock. Yeah. Might not be the right play, but I don't really care. Let's just pile all of the Titan damage onto you. And I can't really play anything, so let's pump them up one. And I get a bunch of mana. Scuttle, scuttle, bitch. I mean, it kind of sucks that this guy has been stuck on three land, and I do feel bad for that, but I don't feel bad for the fact that this is still really fun to do. Alright, so if he attacks Daretti again, yeah, I didn't think that would happen. So can I kill him this turn? That is the million-dollar question. It may or may not actually be worth $1 million. Oh, I lost the flip. Let's get the Mystifying Maze out. So I'm going to swing, trigger, deal one there and two here. Let's see here, I can pump them up four to deal 10 damage. 16. Yeah, let's get that two out of the way. So 16 damage will bring him down to 11. And then I can Scuttling Doom Engine. I think. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. So, oops. Hit him for 16. And then bring him down to 5. Have I used Daretti yet? No, okay. Bring him down to 5. And then Daretti and grab back Bogard and Hellkite. Why can't I grab Bogard and Hellkite? It is an artifact. What the hell? All permanents are artifacts in addition to their other types. All cards and aren't on are colorless. Oh, he's not an artifact. Oh, snap. Well, I read that wrong. Silly me. Shit. You know what? I don't think it's that big of a deal. Because all of my stuff's going to untap. Let's see. Okay. So all of my stuff untaps at least. I read that wrong. I thought these became artifacts. That is my bad. Definitely. It still works out in a kind of cool way just for the fact that I got to untap everything. Let's just hope he doesn't have... Well, I guess Austere Command wouldn't be the end of the world. Oh, oh my god, he's got the Mellowcraft down for sure. So Yeah, I just swing in now with the Titan, and I should have that. That should be game. I mean, he could have swords, but that's fine. I'm gonna go ahead and draw three cards. And a good three it is. Actually, I don't even need to. I'll attack, but I'll have the backup plan with Scuttling Doom Engine. At least this game, I actually did something and didn't win off of a greedy opponent. I feel a little bit better about that. I won because this guy got royally fucked when it came to mana. Dropping a Microsynth Lattice is really risky against white because they're probably going to run Austere Command and they can destroy all of my artifacts. All right, let's run in with the Inferno Titan. See if he has that condemn. Not sure what he's waiting on. Not sure at all. And that should be all she wrote. Was the condemn. I knew it. Well, you know what's actually good, though? This does work with sacrificing him as an artifact. I know that one does. Because these are all artifacts. And now I just get back Dreamstone Hedron, sacrificing Scuttling Doom Engine. Scuttle, scuttle. That was the game. This still doesn't feel like a marathon, so maybe I'll play another one.